If I go for a 5-mile run, how much pollution am I taking in a big city? How much is happening in the home? So I've been invited by Dyson to partner with them on this project. The idea really means a lot to me, to monitor how much air pollution goes into a typical day and what we can do to counteract that and to combat it. I'm a UN Clean Air Ambassador because I recognise how important it is that everybody has that clean air to exercise in. I'm trying to encourage people to take part in sport, to be physically active.
So inside the backpack, we've got a box here, which contains the sensors which are measuring air quality. Paula took one of our bags, went for a day in London, a number of different places, including busy streets, bridges, and Green Park, to be able to monitor the air she breathes. We measure down to PM2.5, which is particulate matter. There are solid particulate in suspension in the air. And we also measure NO2, which is a key aspect in traffic pollution. So since you took the bag, we had a look at the data inside and trying to interpret what has been captured during the day. What we saw on the day is for the NO2, we saw much higher level indoor than outdoor. It's probably to the fact that some of these NO2 sources are generated inside that indoor environment, and you probably have a very well sealed place, so it stays inside.
So this is the NO2 graph. And I was really surprised to see that levels are generally higher indoors, with a big spike when I was, I think that's when I was using the cleaning products, when I was cooking. So different things that we do in the house are actually making it more polluted than outside. And then the other thing we were measuring was the PM2.5.
On PM2.5 is a slightly different story, where that background level is very similar throughout the day. There are a number of events here you've got which create these very high spikes. Do you remember what they could be?
The slightly smaller spike is when we first came outside and we were around Elephant and Castle, then it goes up, and then for Lambeth Bridge and around Victoria. I think they're the three main spike areas there. So when there's more buses, I guess, and a lot of emissions going on. And nice to see that when you're in the park, the air is a little bit cleaner and better for us to be, certainly for us to be exercising in.
It's something which is quite important, because as you go on, you run in the park, you breathe a lot of air. So having cleaner air is very important for you.
I think I really came into this project with quite an open mind, just wanting to be able to learn something about air quality, air pollution. But I'm not sure I expected it to be as interesting as it has been. And I guess I thought beforehand that maybe when traffic was idling was the worst time, but actually it's the pulling away and the acceleration that it releases the most into the atmosphere. And I was really surprised to see that the actual NO2 levels were much higher inside the house than they were outside, and that they went up when I started to cook something, particularly in oil. Running in the parks in London is something that's very close to my heart. So even if you're going to go for a run in London, that's probably one of the best places to run. No, I mean, I think the project has definitely been worth doing it. When we all understand what we're fighting to improve, then we make a much stronger army, if you like, to fight against it and to try and make a difference.